Hi everyone, it's Derek with the Southwest Social Business Team, and we're here in the network operation control, and I have Becky, who's one of our meteorologists here in the NOC, and we're monitoring Winter Storm Stella. Many of you might currently be affected by the winter storm. We have a travel advisory online at southwest.com, so go check that out to see if your current flight potentially is affected or if a future flight that you're taking within the next several days is affected as well. So Becky, thank you for taking some time to chat with me today.
You're very welcome.
Awesome. So Becky has been monitoring the forecast of the winter storm so that way she can provide the information and advise the rest of the network operation control here about what this storm might be doing. So Becky, tell me what we're looking at right here.
Well, there's about seven of us on the team here, so I don't want you to think that I'm doing all of this by myself. But what we're looking at is a couple times a day we provide a weather briefing to the people that make the decisions on whether a flight's going to be canceled or delayed or whatever. And we update everybody here in the company on the storm. And we use these graphics systems just to make the computer maps easier for everybody to understand. So what we're looking at here are just a couple of maps here that show the impacts of Stella, how much snow is going to fall in each one of these cities. Which ones are under winter storm warning, like a threat snow warning, a blizzard. So we try to make it easy for everybody to understand. And then how much snow is going to fall in each one of these cities so we can plan when it's going to be falling as well. So that's what these two monitors are telling you. These are nothing more than computer graphics.
Okay. And these two specifically, Becky? These are sent out to employees as well, or some employees receive these?
Yeah,
so they're
these
aware.
Are all posted within our website. So you can go on the website and you can pick out these weather maps to see for yourselves.
Okay. Yep. All right, fantastic. Now moving along here, what is this screen?
Well, this one just shows us what's going on the last 2 hours across the nation as far as satellite is concerned. Where are the clouds now? Where have they been the last 2 hours? Where are they moving? And it also gives me a radar depiction. Where are the thunderstorms? How tall are the thunderstorms? We're watching right now some rain moving into Atlanta. It's not just Stella that we're keeping an eye on. We are responsible for monitoring the weather for every single city where we fly. So we're not only watching the big storms, but we're watching what's going on as far as wind or fog or regular old rain or cloud high ceilings. Every place that we fly to in the U.S. and the Caribbean and Central America, we're monitoring all of that. So I can go on here and see a lot of different things. I'm watching right now a few little thunderstorms here just to the east of Orlando, which is one of our bigger hubs. And then we've got some more showers just off the coast there. That'll be moving in. So we'll be watching those to affect Tampa pretty soon and also Orlando. So that's just regular old rain. But then we're also going to be watching the snow that's falling right now in Chicago and up here in Milwaukee. Now this only tells me what's happening right now. It doesn't tell me what's going to happen.
Sure.
The computer here, I can ask it, what do you think, Mr. Computer, is going to happen in the next 2 hours? And I can go ahead and get a forecast here of what the computer thinks is going to happen. That may or may not happen.
Sure.
So I have to go and look at a lot of other different computer models in order to determine what really is going to happen. What do I think? Maybe I agree with this, maybe I don't. So I have to look at a lot of different things, and we all do.
Okay.
A lot of different computer models to figure out what's going to happen.
So in the process of preparing for Stella, of course, looking at that forecast, trying to understand what's happening now and what potentially could happen in the future. What was that dialogue like as you and the rest of the meteorologists were looking at these maps?
Well, we noticed this, I want to say it was 10 days ago, 12 days ago, our computer models were showing a big storm system barreling on down out of Canada. It's called an Alberta Clipper, and we were watching it two weeks ago or so, watching it come on down, and you know, kind of thinking that you don't ever want to give somebody a two-week heads-up notice, you know? Sunday night, 2 weeks from now, this is going to happen because that's a great forecast to make. But we knew something big was going to happen, so we've been watching it very closely. And then I would say about 4 days out, we're starting to tell people this is something we're going to need to watch very closely. We don't actively start making decisions as far as canceling flights until we have a pretty good handle on it. And again, the meteorology department does not do that anyway. We tell the decision makers what to do, but we're constantly in contact with everybody here on the bridge and everybody making the decisions. If they want to know specifically what's going to happen in Baltimore, they'll come to us. What do you think is going to happen in Baltimore? When is it going to start?
And you're able to provide all of that information.
When's it going to end? How much snow is going to fall? Yeah, that's what we do here.
So has the storm shifted any from the 10 days out that you all first noticed?
It really has not. No? It's been pretty much on the money. And okay. It's kind of surprising to see something like that 10 days out hit.
And then continue in that pattern.
Absolutely. So we knew this was going to be a pretty big storm, and especially a big one for the Northeast, and it's looking like that's going to happen.
Okay. Well, now that we're in the thick of things with Winter Storm Stella, I know we're not out of the woods yet.
Right.
But what are you all looking for from today moving forward? What will those updates look like that you'll provide to the rest of the team?
Well, we're going to continue to update these maps here. What we're watching in particular for overnight tonight, Midway doesn't look so bad right now. We've got cameras up there to show you the gates. So you can see the ground looks pretty good. It doesn't look like it's covered in snow.
Mm-hmm.
The planes aren't covered in snow, so everything, you can see the vehicles there driving around without any problems. However, we're watching the winds up there at Midway. They're going to start to shift during the overnight hours. They're going to become more of a northeasterly direction. And what that's going to do is bring in what's called lake effect snow. Now, when you have lake effect snow, one house can get 16 inches of snow. You go two blocks over, and that house can see no snow at all.
Wow.
Yeah, that's a trouble.
Big difference.
Yeah, so if that one band of heavy snow gets Midway, they could get clobbered while O'Hare may not.
Okay.
Or vice versa. So we're going to have to watch it very closely tonight and see where these bands of snow set up. But in the meantime, our people up there in Midway are prepared for some heavy overnight snow.
Sure.
Right now we're thinking it'll be maybe 4 to 8 inches of snow total from Midway, maybe 4 inches of that falling during the overnight hours. So that's what we're going to be watching. So they've got the de-icing trucks ready up there and everything.
Right. And aside from Midway, are there any other
cities
that we're monitoring possibly more closely than others?
Well, we always monitor Midway. That's the one that has the most flights for us. So we're watching that closely for tonight. Now, as we go into overnight tonight, it's going to be Baltimore that starts to see some rain mixing in with some snow, and then heavy snow by tomorrow morning, and then we could get some sleet mixed in with that.
Wow.
So that's a big giant mess. And then we'll be looking at that storm system gradually making its way on up the East Coast, hitting the New York metros. And the latest is that Newark and LaGuardia could see 20 inches of snow.
20
inches of snow. They're also looking at a blizzard warning. So not only are they looking at heavy, heavy snow that's going to reduce visibility, so you're hardly going to be able to see in front of you, less than a quarter of a mile. We're also looking at very windy conditions. So we're looking at winds up there gusting as high as 45 miles, close to 50 miles per hour.
That is incredible.
So you don't want to be in New York.
Well,
or Providence, or Connecticut, or Boston,
sure.
All the way up to Portland, Maine.
Hey, yeah. I mean, but if you're in those cities, hopefully you can stay warm, and of course, check out southwest.com. Well, Becky, thank you so much
thank
for your
you.
Time. It's a pleasure to learn a little bit more about how you all are monitoring the storm and helping our customers. So I'm going to let you get back to work here. So for everyone else at home, if you don't mind, just go to southwest.com, check out our travel advisory where you'll be able to learn more information about the storm as well as the cities that are affected by the storm. Thank you all, and we'll continue to provide updates.